नमस्कार। आप सभी लोग अपने अपने घरों में सकुशल होंगे। इसी कामना के साथ हम बात करते हैं अपने टॉपिक की। सो स्टूडेंट, इन अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव टॉक अबाउट द मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ द कॉकरोच, इन विच वी हैव टॉक डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स स्पेशली रिलेटेड टू दैट वन एंड अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ द कॉकरोचेस एंड सो ऑन। सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ऑल दीज थिंग्स यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट देयर ईटिंग हैबिट्स, external features and their body divided into different parts, right? It may be how they can be shows their structures over there. So you will have lesson about their head, which contains compound eyes, antenna and different parts of the mouth, right? Later on then you will have also talk about that they can shows all those things according to their different parts one, as I explain you all these parts in detail in your videos. So you must just seen over there that how these parts, labrum or the mandibles or the these maxillae, labrium and the hypopharynx, thorax, as well as their about their wings, types of wings and how their legs can be work out over there, means all these things can be always helpful for them, that they can be always necessary for the developmental of their morphological structures of the these cockroaches. Let's move to talk about the how they can be also divided into males and females, means how we can capable to understand or seen the male and the female part of the that cockroach one. But let's move to another thing, that is the anatomy of the cockroach, means we have to study about all described things, especially if we talk about the body wall, right, and anatomical structures, especially if we talk about their body wall. Generally the body wall, which is contains a developed with the help of cuticle, epidermis and basement membrane, they contain the, these layers. Evenly they are cuticle impermeable throughout the water because it can be a thick and non-cellular surface layer, and epidermis consists of the single layer of the columnar cells and enclosing the some glands over there. If we talk about the body cavity, generally if we the cockroaches have a coelomates, means but they are the true coelom occurs only in the embryonic stages, means generally they are the coelomates, means in which the coelomic cavity is present over there, right? But especially they have a true cavity, body cavity, only in that particular conditions which is found into the their embryological state only. In adult we can say it is found a small cavities around the gonads, or we can say this body cavity is filled with a hemolymph that is called known as hemoscale, right? On the other hand we can talk about the endoskeleton. As you know that the cockroaches have the exoskeletons, right, and extended into the body and form the endoskeletons elements. Especially these provide the attachment to the muscles, hence they can be called the apodemes. Evenly if we talk about the digestive systems, especially under this topic, that is anatomy, right? First of all we have to know about that this digestive systems. As we all of you know about that the alimentary canal of the cockroaches is always divided into different categories. The digestive system can be divided in different categories, especially alimentary canal and digestive gland. As we can say, if we talk about alimentary canal of the cockroach, that is 6 to 7 cm in the length one, and it can always contain the different parts of that one. We can say foregut, midgut, hindgut, and this foregut contains the different parts, that is the preoral cavity, mouth, pharynx, oesophagus, crop, gizzard, and on the other hand the digestive gland, that's salivary gland, hepatic cecci, and the glands of the mesenteron, right? So all these glands can play a very important role. And if we talk about the structures, as you can see the structures of their alimentary canal over here, the development, the growth or the development of their whole alimentary canal from this mouth, or we can say mouth part to their rectum, or you can say anus or colon cavity one, means it can just sequences like this one. If you can see, especially in this category I want to just show you That is, it will start from over here, and this is the whole alimentary canal of the cockroach over there. Right, so we can say these are different organs, different parts of this alimentary canal are found over there. So if we can talk about in details, especially in details, it is divided into different categories. Right, that I already told you, that is foregut, midgut and the hindgut. Right, but how these different guts can be play the different roles over there? Right, for that we can take, if we talk about there, this foregut one, so it can always have different parts over there. So first of all, we can say that it is the anterior part of the alimentary canal, means starting point of the alimentary canal. It is surrounded by the biting and chewing type of mouth parts, right? And food is crushed initially by the mandibles and the mixes with the saliva and the passes to the short tubule, that is known as the pharynx over there, right? And we can say the pharynx is the true band of the narrow tube over there, which can always helpful for us, or sorry, for the cockroaches, that it is the pharynx can always turn blend or to join a narrow tube that is known as oesophagus, which can always allow to pass through the neck and open into the sac like structure that is known as the crop one, right? And these crops can be always helpful for these cockroaches, or we can say the crop is a large P-shaped sac structure where the food is stored over there. On the other hand, these animals or these cockroaches can also shows that the food can be transferred from the crop, right, and to the conical muscular part that is called gizzard or the proventriculus, having the outer layer of the thick circular muscles. And after that, the gizzard has the 6 large chitinous teeth in that particular part over there, right? Means this gizzard can be always have a large number of teeth over there, or we can the 6 chitinous, which can always help for the crushing of the food. Or we can say the fine bristles in its grooves are found over there, therefore it can be efficient to grind the food particles and act as the straining apparatus over there. After that, we can say the gizzard makes an end of the foregut, means gizzard is at the last part of the foregut, and the whole foregut is lined by this cuticle protecting an alimentary canal from the rough food particles, and posterior end projected into the form of narrow and into the midgut called the stomodial valve. Entire foregut is lined with the cuticle over there, right? So this way it can be always helpful for the grinding of the food in these parts, means it can be always helpful for the grinding of the food material, especially into the cockroach. After that, the food can passes into the another part that is known as midgut, or the we can say it is also known as mesenteral. As in the foregut, right, it can be passes to the midgut. If especially if, as you can see in the diagram, this is the up to here, after this is the midgut over there, right? So how the food can be works over there, especially it is a short narrow tube of the uniform diameter, means the diameter is not changeable over there, and up to it contains at least 6 to 8 blind tubules called the gastric or hepatic cacae, present in the junctions of the foregut and midgut, secrete digestive juices. Means especially in this, it is a type of the, you can say the intestine one, which can contain the different numbers of rings tubules, which can be known as the gastric glands, or it can be able to secrete the different digestive juices over there. The midgut is the major organ of the digestion and absorption. Means it can always helpful for the digestion as well as the absorption, and the posterior part of midgut has a sphincter that keeps the food closed. Means that can be always helpful for the closing of that food material over there in the posterior part of the midgut. If we talk about the next, that is called hindgut, or we can say proctodyne, right? Especially it is broader than the midgut, and this divisible into ileum, colon and the rectum parts, means these are different parts of the intestine. And ileum is the shorter and a narrow bearing short spines, right, as well as we can say a ring of the about 100 to 150 fine yellow color thread like filaments are found over there, which are known as Malpighi tubules over there. As you can see, especially in the colorful diagram over there, these are the Malpighi tubules are found over there. Right. Generally, these Malpighi tubules are joined to the ileum, right? And the colon is a white coiled tube which can does not contain spines, while the rectum is last part of the hindgut in their particular conditions. If we can say, generally, these Malpighi tubules can play a very important role for the excretory in nature. Means they can be acts like an excretory organ in this cockroach, right? Or we can say generally these can help for the removal of the excretory product of the hemolymphon or hemocele, right? And as you know that the ileum, the next part that is ileum, ileum is short and narrow and colon coil to the wide one, right? Only we can say the colon is a wide coil tube which can does not contain any spines, and while the rectum is the last part of the hindgut. At the last, we can say the papillae present in the rectum absorb water and salt from the undigested food, and the rectum thus open outside by the anus, which is lies below the 10th tergum. Right. So this way, the total waste material can be passes out or can be acts into the one. Evenly in the cockroach, if we talk about the salivary glands, because as I told you in the starting that the digestive systems in cockroach, it can especially alimentary gland and some digestive glands also. So in the same way, there are two salivary glands which are present in the cockroach. If we can say the each gland has the glandular lobes and the receptacles or the reservoirs. We can say the glandular lobes consist of the several irregular white color lobules which are provided with the collecting ducts and secrete the saliva. Right, evenly the two glands duct, two salivary gland unite and the common salivary duct, this wall transparent bag like structure called the salivary receptacles or the store of the saliva in their body. Evenly the common salivary receptacle duct runs below the oesophagus and through the neck and the opens base of the tongue or tongue, we can say hypopharynx, and the salivary gland open into the common salivary duct into the peripatal cavity. The saliva contains the amylase, chitinase and the cellulase. Means it can always contain the different types of enzymes which can always help for the digestion of their food one over there. Then we have to talk about the next system, that is the respiratory systems. Especially as you can, everybody knows the respiratory systems is generally comprises of the network of the blind resting white in tube, that is called trachea, as well as the trachea are the connected to the outside of the 10 pairs of the lateral apertures, that is called spiracles. Right, means generally these spiracles, the two pair of spiracles occur in the thorax and 8 pair of the present in the abdomen, as we have already talked in the previous topic. If we can say during the rest conditions, some of the spiracles are opened to so that the oxygen can be diffused continuously reaching the body blood and present in the terminal regions of the tracheoles. Or we can say generally the exchange of the gases occurs between the living cells and the body fluid and expands, right, especially with them on expansion of the abdomen draws fresh air into the tracheal system through the stigmata and its contractions expels foul air outside of their body. Evenly, or we can say that it can be different parts through which it can capable to exchange their gases directly. Especially we all have to just learn only this one. As I have told you that these tracheoles are present over there, and the terminal parts of the tracheoles contains fluid that is facilitates the exchanging of O2 and the CO2 by the diffusion process. Or during the intense activity of fluid is withdrawn from the tracheoles so that a more empty surface area is available and air reaches to the tissue cells directly for the quick O2 supplies in their body, right? So we can say the blood has no role for play in the respiratory gas exchange. As well as been learned in the human beings, that blood can be always helpful for the transporting or exchanging of the gases also, because the blood can carry the deoxygenated blood over to for the exhaling, and oxygenated blood can be continues to provide the inhaled air throughout the body. So this is the mechanism through which they can be always helpful for the surviving or supplying of these things in the body one. Evenly, if we talk about another system, that is blood vascular system, or we can say the circulatory systems, right? So it can also play a very important role in the cockroach one, because they do not have the blood like us, but they have a special fluid that is known as hemocyanin in their body, which is present. We especially talk about the circulatory systems. Generally, the circulatory system of the cockroach is the open type, means they do not have the any vessels, they do not have the any arteries that blood can for the flow. Means generally, we can say they have a poorly developed vessels are present in their body, or we can say that. So such type of circulatory system is known as open type of circulatory system, or we can say the blood vessels are poorly developed and blood flows freely into the body cavity, that is called hemocyte. Or we can say the visceral organs located in the hemocyte and bathed in the blood or the hemolymph, means there is their blood is that is called the lymph or hemolymph, and where it is filled, that is known as hemocyte. And all their body internal organs, that is known as visceral part, the which can play a vital role for their mechanism, for their body functioning, they all are bathed into the hemolymph. Evenly, we can say it contains the colorless plasma and corpuscles, that is called hemocytes, right, in their body. Or we can say especially that as a different specific part one, or we can generally they have the heart one also, means we can say heart chamber open into the next chamber through the ventricular wall. If we can say directly talk about their heart one, especially the blood is kept in circulating by the long tubular dorsal muscular funnel shaped, that is 13 chamber of heart are present over there. Means these are the we can say in according to the diagram here, you can say these are the different chambers of the heart over there, right, which can be always supplies the blood through their tubular or dorsal muscular funnel shaped structure over there. Or we can say that the heart lies along the dorsal line and thorax and abdomen. The each chamber of the heart is open into the one in front of it. The opening of the guarded by the that is ventricular valves, which allow the forward flow of the blood at the posterior end of the chambers, except the last, it is paired up of the holes, that is called ostia, in their body part over there, right? Means you have to just note down that the at the posterior end the chamber, except the last one, right, in the pairs of the holes, that is called ostia on the either side, and the ostia are guarded by the auricular valves, especially as we talk about the ventricular valves, and then the ostia is guarded by the auricular valves, which allows the blood to pass into the heart from the hemocyte. Means it can be always blood can pass from over their conditions. Okay, and after that, you all must know that how the blood circulation take place into the cockroaches. Right, as I have told you that the heart chambers contract one after the other rapidly, means all the chambers are attached to each other, right, as you can see directly into the their body one, right, as you guys are seeing into the body one. These are the especially chambers, means this is the chamber, this is the chamber, these are the different chambers, and they are attached to each other with the help of opening, that is called ostia, right? So due to these conditions, they can be also helpful for supplying the blood, right? Or we can say the blood can be always pushes the blood into the anterior aorta and as well as the lateral excretory arteries. From the aorta, the blood can be passes into the head and the sinus and into the previsceral and the perineural sinuses in their body. And the circulatory system, if you can recreate it can be always from heart to aorta, aorta to head sinus, pulmonary sinus and previsceral sinus and the pericardial sinus. So this is the main mechanism of the supplying of the blood circulatory systems in the cockroach, which can be found over there. So you all must understand about all these things and try to prepare your notes easily and cleanly with the diagram.